Please stand for morning prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O suffering Jesus, we give you glory, thanks, and praise. God, you say to us, when many things seem to be going wrong, trust me. When your life feels increasingly out of control, pay extra attention to what you're grateful for. These are supernatural responses, and they can lift you above your circumstances. Complaining can set you on a path that is a downward spiral. But choosing trust and gratitude, though it may seem irrational, will guide you to steady ground. God, help me to choose that trust and that gratitude always, but especially when things are weighing on my mind. And the people say,
it's the most beautiful time of the year.
Good morning, Narex Hall. This is NERX TV, your high school madness and information station. Now it's time for your wake-up call.
Good morning, Narex Hall.
Today is Thursday, October 7th.
I'm Loeva.
And I'm Sarah. And now to People with Sports.
Good morning, Marker fans! I'm Julie.
I'm Anna.
The regular sports people did not come, so we are here to fill in.
We're the normal ones.
Yeah, we are. All right, now time for some game day results. Woo. The freshman field hockey team tied Koryasu 1-1.
Now
let's go!
Hey! Now for today's sports. Freshman field hockey plays Burroughs at 5:30 p.m. The golf team has a match against Ursuline at Paradise Valley at 4 p.m. The cross country team runs in the MWAA conference meet at St. Vincent Park. Varsity race at 4 p.m. JV at 5 p.m. Varsity and field hockey teams play MICDS at MICDS, varsity at 4:15, and JV at 5:30 p.m. Now, Julia.
That's not my name.
Julie. Oopsie daisy. I have a joke for you.
I'm ready.
Why do candles always go on the top of cakes?
Why, Anna?
What a great question. Because it's hard to light them from the bottom.
Oh my God!
Oh. Thanks, and back to the anchors.
Representatives from Maryville University, University of Dayton, University of Alabama in Huntsville, and Webster University will be in the library today during contact. Interested students should sign up and score. Thank you, Mrs. Carr and Mrs. Sumter.
And now to Lydia with an info report.
Hey, Markers. Are you getting ready for spooky season? Well, if you're over the age of 12 and plan to go trick-or-treating on Halloween night, don't visit Chesapeake, Virginia. Apparently, anyone of the age 12 and older would go to jail if caught trick-or-treating on Halloween in this town of Virginia. While no teens were actually arrested for this law, it was still written in law for about 50 years before the town decided to adjust it. The only reason it was written was so that police officers had a valid reason to arrest any teenagers making trouble on Halloween night. Let's listen to a clip from Jimmy Kimmel Live talking about this town in Virginia.
All the candy. Halloween is not all fun and games. It's important to remember that. And in Chesapeake, Virginia, if you trick or treat after a certain age, you could wind up in jail.
The city of Chesapeake, Virginia is threatening jail time for Halloween troublemakers over 12 years old. The city's ordinance code states, if anyone over 12 years of age participates in trick-or-treat or any similar activity, he or she shall be guilty of a misdemeanor and shall be punished by a fine of not less than $25 nor more than $100 or by confinement in jail for not more than 6 months.
What's going on? Don't get me wrong, I do think trick-or-treating should be limited to little kids, not teenagers, but not with the threat of incarceration.
But because the law was so outdated, in March 2019, they changed the age limit to 14. This is the law written in law. If any person over the age of 14 years shall engage in the activity commonly known as trick-or-treat, or any other activity of similar character or nature under any name whatsoever, he or she shall be guilty of a Class 4 misdemeanor. Nothing herein shall be construed as prohibiting any parent, guardian, or other responsible person having lawfully in his or her custody a child of 14 years old or younger from accompanying said child. So not only did they change the maximum age, but as stated in the video, they also made it a Class 4 misdemeanor, which is the lowest level for a criminal offense in Virginia. The town also encouraged an 8 p.m. curfew for anyone who was allowed to trick-or-treat, meaning everyone 14 and younger. Apparently, if this legal trick-or-treater was you in Virginia, you'd also be convicted with a Class 4 misdemeanor because you didn't obey the curfew. Anyway, happy soon-to-be Halloween. Back to the anchors.
Whoa. Looking for something to do during contact today? Have you ever played spikeball? Coach Jody will be outside on the field with two areas to play, so grab a partner and come out.
Freshman Stugo officer candidates are reminded that campaign platforms are due today by noon. This includes any freshman running for president, vice president, secretary, treasurer, communications rep, or a student advisory board. Candidates with questions should see Mr. Kensing during contact today. Today's birthdays are Audrey Travers and Ava Turner. Happy birthday!
Today's lunch is cheese tortellini with pesto with garlic bread and green beans.
Yum. Today's senior of the day, is Claire McBride.
So if you see her in the hall, ask her about the time she got stalked.
Today is an F day, so have a footloose.
Friday, comma, almost.
Fools rush in. F day. And now to a PSA from your friendly neighborhood homeroom teacher.
It's so tough. Shawty,